I'm going to walk on over. Amy Fujiwara, an award-winning bartender co-author of the Cocktail Handbook, is here to teach us how to make two sparkling cocktails that will kick your 2016 into high gear.
I'm going to come on this side, help
on
out.
Hello, Amy.
Hello. It's New Year's already. I can't believe it. No,
I know.
I cannot believe it.
I know. And I'm excited. I've decided that I would love to have a bartender here every
It would make
once
life enjoyable.
A week would be nice.
It would.
But
we're
gosh,
nice to have
I wish people were there. The fragrance and the what do we have right here?
Yeah,
in front of
well,
us?
We're going to make some champagne drinks and just to jazz it up a little instead of just plain old champagne. Mm-hmm. If you're having people over, you want to jazz it up, make it look like you've done a lot of stuff to prepare.
Smart. Okay.
Make some simple syrups. They're really easy, and they're going to look like you've been very busy, working so hard for your guests.
Can you buy simple syrup, is it something you
can buy? You can buy it, but it's so easy to make. It's really just equal parts sugar and water,
okay.
And then add a fruit or an herb or both.
There you go.
Whatever you want to do, you know, mix it up. Everything's good.
And I love how you recycled some old bottles, so that's very cool, very light.
Thank
I love the presentation.
Thank you.
So, what are the flavors we have right here?
So today, this one is a blackberry sage, and this one is a honey lemon ginger.
That. I can smell the ginger.
Yeah.
I can smell it.
Yeah.
Smells so good.
And they're really, I'm telling you, it's so easy to make.
And well, a lot of people think when you think of New Year's, you think of champagne.
Yep.
So this kind of takes it to another level. Let's start making, what's our first drink?
Let's do, you want to start with the blackberry?
Oh,
sure.
I like it.
Okay.
I like it.
So pour just about.
Oh, I didn't know you were going to make me do it.
Pressure's
on.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so
just
tell
a
me
little,
how
much. Maybe like a half ounce or so. Yeah, that's good.
Heard
that's
that.
Good.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, and then all you have to do is just add your champagne.
I have a question. When you're making champagne drinks, is it always is there an order? Do you put this the syrup or the bitters or something in first and then the champagne?
Usually you do. Yeah.
Ah, okay.
Yeah,
I didn't know that.
Usually you do.
Good to know. Good to know.
You know. I guess it probably doesn't really matter, but it looks cooler.
It does look cooler. And the flavors, just the smell just comes right on out.
So
what's great is before you came on, we actually opened the champagne. And, of course, you've got the pop. You've got the bubbles.
Oh, look at that. That's so beautiful.
Nice. So we'll do that. So the blackberry's in there. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. The sage is in there. But what you can't, I mean, the thyme, I'm sorry.
Yep.
You can just add a little thyme right there and maybe a little, you know, a little lemon twist.
Look at how beautiful that is.
Doesn't that look pretty?
Well, and I love champagne, too, because
of
the bubbles. It looks like it's just dancing.
It's a party.
Mm-hmm.
It's a party happening.
So the next drink is called Honey New Year.
Honey New Year.
Honey New Year. And how do you make that
one? Am I making this one?
Can you?
Okay, so what do we do right here? I'm going to take this.
Pretty much the same thing.
All right, go ahead. And how much are you said about a...
I say about an ounce. You know, more sweeter, less is not so sweet.
All right, I'm going to hold it right about there.
Okay.
Oh, gosh, you could really smell
the honey. You know what to do here. I know, it's such a nice syrup.
So the key, I guess, is making the syrup at home and making it, you know...
And you don't... It's just like an hour, you know, just make it, let it sit.
Okay.
And then it's good to go. You can make it like the night before.
So sugar and water.
Equal parts is, I think, is best. You could do maybe more water than sugar, but it's a little more solid, viscous if you do equal parts. And then you just add whatever you want. I mean, really anything goes.
Oh,
look how nice that looks.
They're beautiful.
Great.
Thank you.
And if you wanted to kick it up even more, you could add some booze. Some vodka, as maybe like an elderflower liqueur, whiskey.
Great. Mm-hmm. Now, Amy, not everybody likes alcohol, so if you can stick around, in our next segment, we're going to do a mocktail.
Sure. Yep.
You're
now,
right.
Coming up around the corner, this is kind of interesting, Amy. I want to hear your opinion about this because the New Year's party of the year is just around the corner, and it's